Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today we're diving into the world of Power BI to craft the ultimate timeline visual. We're going to take things up a notch by leveraging an HTML template and harnessing the power of ChatGPT to tailor it specifically for Power BI. This means it will dynamically respond to filters, seamlessly adjust its size, giving you a dynamic visualization experience. But before we jump in, if you haven't already, hit the subscribe button. We have got a ton of awesome business intelligence and data science tutorials coming your way. Now, grab yourself a cup of coffee, sit back and watch. I always get questions about how to create a proper timeline and show it inside Power BI. And there is no default timeline visual in Power BI, and even if you try to get more visuals and search for timelines, you'll find few options, but to be honest, none of them that present a timeline properly. Like, they have some okay options. For example, this one is a timeline, but it looks more like a Gantt chart, not a timeline. What other options we have? For example, this one. Now this one, okay, it looks like a horizontal timeline, but you can see how limited the presentation is. There is no much formatting you can do, just have a text here and it automatically populates, and sometimes it doesn't come in the right location, overlapping and so on. So today I want to show you a way to create amazing timelines that are visually appealing and meets your expectation. And to do this, we're going to design it using HTML visual. Let's jump in and see how we can do this. First of all, let's look at the data just to understand what I'm trying to do. So I have this data, I have list of companies. I'll just sort them. List of companies and their milestones over the years, and we have description for each of the milestones. And if you notice, some of them have, for example, 10 milestones, some of them 8, some of them 7, and so on. So we don't have fixed number of milestones, and the years are different. Obviously, each company has their own timeline. So we want to create a timeline that can respond to slicers and adjust the number of milestones automatically. Let's start by importing the HTML visual. Get more visuals, search for HTML. We're going to use this visual. We have used it in the episode where we covered how to embed HTML in Power BI. If you haven't watched that episode, I recommend you watch it because we'll build on some of the techniques we used there. So add, and we have the visual imported. Now let's add a slicer first for the company. And that will feed in the company. Let's format it to a tile. And let's remove the header and even remove the background. Now let's bring the HTML visual and resize it. Here we go. The next step is to find a proper HTML template for timeline. And for that, we're going to use an online templates for timelines. I'll provide you a link for this website. It has so many templates. Let's have a look. For example, you have this horizontal timeline. You have this one. You have this one. This is another horizontal one. Let's find a proper one. You can either use this. Ah, this is a nice one. I think I'll go with this one. So it has milestones, you have the date, and it looks as a vertical timeline with different milestones and dates. So I'll try this one. But you can follow the same steps we're going to use and choose any other visual. We're going to use the HTML code and the CSS code, we need to combine them into one single code. And if you're not, again, comfortable with coding this yourself, we can use the famous ChatGPT. It will do it for you. All you need to do is to copy the HTML code and CSS code and provide it to ChatGPT and ask it to create one single HTML code for you. I have it already prepared here. So I provide this request. I have the HTML and CSS codes. Can you combine them into one HTML code? And here I provided the HTML code. And if you go down, you'll find also here I provided the CSS code. And I sent the request. And ChatGPT came back with the combined code. So that's it. We have the code combined. Before we go further, let's try how it looks like. Let's copy this code. And there's one thing we need to do, just like we have done in the HTML episode. We need to replace the double quote with three double quotes and one double quote. Let's just paste the code from ChatGPT and hit replace all. So that's it. We have the code. Let's copy and see how it looks in Power BI. So we go to Power BI. Let's create new column. We call it HTML, call it one because we'll have more than one version. Open the double quotes, paste, and hit enter. Let's select the visual and feed it in to the values. So here we go. We have the timeline came as expected, as is, without any editing. Now let's start formatting this. So the way you want to format this, you need to update the code. But again, we're going to use ChatGPT to do this for us. As a start, we don't have days and months, we only have years. So I want to get rid of this and move the years inside the circles. Let's ask ChatGPT to do this for us. So you can see here, I sent another request. Now, can you update the code by removing the day and month and keeping only the year inside the circle? And again, it updated the code. I don't need to know what's going on inside it. Just take it as is and use the replace all. And let's copy this. Now let's go back to ChatGPT. Create a new calculated column. So now if I duplicate this page, I just need to update the code. Let's replace it with HTML2. And you can see the code removed the other milestones. It kept one for me just as a sample and expects me to add the other milestones. But it did the job. It has only the year inside the circle. It got rid of the month and the day. This is nice. Now here where things get interesting. Now we have this template. The idea is we want to be able to feed in the milestones to this timeline and it should automatically create new milestones and years based on the data we have. As you can see here, we have the year, which is a column we have. We have the title, which is the milestone for us, for our data. And we have this details, which is the description for us. To do this, there are two parts. The first part is about the data. We need to manipulate the data to have it as a single value because this visual accepts only a single value and we need it to be embedded in the code. And the second part is to update the code to take the milestones as variable. Because if we look at the code, if you go down here, you see that the milestone is static, it's not a variable. So it creates one milestone and it feeds in the year as a static number and the title as a static number and the details as a static number. I know this sounds a bit confusing, but don't worry. I'll show you how to do this step by step. Let's start with the data part. And we're going to do this using Power Query. Let's go to transform data. So in simple terms, we have the company here. It has, each company has many rows per the number of milestones. What we want to do, we want to have one row that's showing all the milestones, the years, and the description. So we want to condense or zip this list into one single value. So to do this, we go home, group by, we keep it basic, by the company, and the new column, the grouped one, we'll name it list, for example. And from the operation here, we select all rows. Just click OK. So what happened here, we have grouped a table contains all the data for each of the companies. So all the milestones data. So if you try to expand this, you will find all the columns containing the milestones for each of the companies. But of course, we can't download it in this way. There is one extra step we need to do. We need to create a calculated column that convert this table to a value for us. And to do this, let's go to add column, custom column, let's call it milestone, and I have an equation ready. I'll just paste it and I'll explain what this equation does. So it creates one value that extracts the data from the list. So we have here the list, we take the year column, the milestone column, and the description. They're zipped together into one list, and we'll have them in this format here. Once we click OK, we'll see how this format looks like. So just take the equation as is. Don't worry, I'll leave you a link with the Power BI file. You can download it and check the formula and try different things. Let's just click OK. So here we go. We have condensed everything to one list. As you can see here, we have the first value, the year, the milestone, and the description, and then the brackets close, and another milestones appear. And as you can see, they have ascending order, just like what we want. So that's it. We have the data part ready. Let's download it. Now, the next part is to update the code, and here where we're going to use ChatGPT again. So here is our conversation with ChatGPT. So my next request would be, now I need to add milestones in the following exact format. So I provided a sample of the format I've created the data with, and I said here I want the code to automatically create separate milestones and add it to the timeline based on the number of provided milestones. So it should automatically know how many milestones I'm providing it. And I want the output to be HTML code only. Again, no need to know what's going on. ChatGPT provided me the full code, as you can see here, and it created a loop function that reads the data from the input, and it gave a sample of the data just exactly like the data I have created. I just need later on to replace this data with my data. Let's see how we're going to do this. Copy the code, do the replace, and copy. So go back to Power BI, right click, new column. I'll name it HTML3 equals, open the double quote, paste the code, and hit enter. So I have a new code is created. Let's just duplicate this and feed in the new column. So we have here a placeholder with three milestones. All what we need to do now to open this code and go where it feeds in the data. So we have here the data, and we need to replace it with our field. So highlight it all, add a double quote, then and, provide the field. Here we go, the milestone, again, and space, double quote. So we have the new code is ready. Hit commit. So here we go. Now we have the milestones are automatically added as per our specific example. So if I select a specific company, the visual should update to our data. But you see here, it doesn't update immediately. I need to leave the page and come back. But don't worry, we'll resolve this in a minute. But let's see. So this is for Alibaba. You can see all the milestones are listed from our data. But here we have a problem because the code was built for 5 milestones only. It doesn't show the background for all the milestones. So again, we're going to use ChatGPT to resolve this. You don't need to do it yourself. So let's just name this page 3 and duplicate it. Have page 4. Now let's go back to ChatGPT and ask it to resolve this for us. I already have done this before. So here the request, when I have many milestones, 10 for example, it doesn't have the title background colored. Can you fix it? So I'm just using natural language. I'm not explaining the code. And it gave me the updated code, just the same process. So now I need to update the code from HTML3 to HTML4. And again, it doesn't render immediately until I leave the page and come back. Now it's rendered. You can see now all the milestones have colors as expected. However, one single color for all the backgrounds. If you want to have more than one color, just the same way, ask ChatGPT to fix this for you. But for our tutorial, we're happy with this. I'll keep it as is. The last thing I want to resolve here is the render. So now when I switch to another company, you can see here the visual looks empty. It doesn't render immediately till I leave the page and come back. So we need one last favor from ChatGPT to resolve this for us. Duplicate this, name it page 5, go back to ChatGPT, and I sent the final request. One last issue I have, I am using Power BI HTML visual for this code. When I apply filter on the milestones, the visual doesn't render until I navigate from the page and I come back. Can you resolve it? So it did actually provided me the updated code and explained to me why it wasn't rendering immediately. It is to do with the Power BI JavaScript API. It doesn't listen to the filter. So it updated the code to listen to the filters. How awesome is that? So we'll do the same process and done. Let's provide the new code. Replace the old one. Here we go. Now you can navigate between companies and everything updates automatically. Creates a timeline for you. One last thing I want to show you here. This timeline, it responds not only to filters but also to size. So if you reduce the size, you can see how the cards are updated, so you don't lose anything. It's not static. So you have a perfect timeline that you can embed with other data here. Again, if you want to change the formats, the background format, the way the text is showing, use ChatGPT and it will do it for you if you are not comfortable with updating the code yourself. So here we go, you have the flexibility to create any kind of timeline just the way you want.